Using the airborne division's ace, extreme mobility, the 82nd plans an aerial end run. Purpose, to trap the aggressor against the Pee Dee River. The Bennettsville Airport plays a vital role here. It must be captured. This is what the Army calls vertical envelopment. All told in swift strike, the largest airborne maneuver ever undertaken in peacetime, the Air Force flies 2,700 troop carrier missions. 12,000 troops, more than one-third the total number in the exercise, are paratrooped. Yet there is only one serious injury per 1,000 jumps. A remarkable example of precision and discipline. Bennettsville Airport, unopposed. The 82nd troopers have flanked the aggressor forces, and the field is theirs. In short order, the captured airfield is a going relay station for the 82nd. On a minute-by-minute schedule, Caribou shuttle in weapons, ammunition, and vehicles. Copters begin moving the men and weapons close to the vulnerable flank and rear of the 101st. The harried aggressors resort to nuclear weapons. Here, a simulated atomic explosion in an effort to head off the enveloping move. But with the 82nd paratroopers already dispersed over a wide area, the nuclear shot fails to stop the battle group. Caught in a closing vise, the 101st begins a desperate effort to escape across the Pee Dee River. The combat engineers are called upon to build a pontoon bridge, and rapidly. The 82nd is making good use now of the artillery they brought in with them. The pressure increases on the 101st. Some screaming eagles get their wings clipped. The engineers come through, however, throw a 60-ton bridge across the river overnight. By dawn, the aggressor division is withdrawing. By several routes. An axiom of war, withdraw until you can regroup and counterattack. The 101st now goes airborne in the Army's own troop carrier, the fantastic turboprop Caribou. In the largest assembly of Caribous ever gathered, in fact. A Caribou is quite an aircraft. It can carry 32 fully equipped troops and deliver them right to the front lines. No reinforced runways needed for this one. Fields, pastures, country roads, beachheads, desert, they're all the same. Not competitive with Air Force troop carriers, the Caribou is designed for large-scale troop and cargo movement within combat areas. Since the first Caribous arrived at operational units less than 3 months before, this is the first chance for most ground commanders to judge the plane. Whereas the tested Army helicopter, versatile, maneuverable, already has been working changes in field tactics. Army aviation craft, fixed and rotary wing, airlifted more than 11,000 troops during swift strike, providing a mobility and fluidity not seen before on this scale. In close tactical support, Air Force fighters fly more than 2,000 combat sorties. The 82nd Airborne Riflemen do what they can to stop the 101st. But this aggressor counterattack is too well organized to stop. The maneuver so far is proving one thing. Airborne troops can mount an extremely effective, fast-moving force, both of attack and counterattack. In addition, swift strike is a proving ground for junior and non-commissioned officers. Continuously thrust into new and volatile situations, they must think as well as fight their way out. Thrown off balance by the 101st's counterattack, the 82nd wards off blows with a series of local firefights. The 101st counterattack pays tangible dividends, and 82nd troopers occupy PW cages for a change. Special forces detachments take their share of captives. At this point, the exercise directors declare swift strike at an end. There is no final decision as to which side won. This is not the purpose of a maneuver, but the ensuing period of study and assessment, the critique of the action, will reveal many things. For example, Army aviation came of age. It showed by the amounts of materiel, the numbers of men carried, that it can affect the course of battle, give the airborne troops even more mobility and punch. For the troop and cargo carrying Caribou, this was a debut, a highly successful one. Ground commanders were impressed by its performance. As for Army Air Force coordination, that gets more than praise, it brings action. The Defense Department decides to merge the Tactical Air Command and Strategic Army Corps into a unified strike command. And the 1-2 punch of Strat the 101st and 82nd Airborne Divisions are rated easily among the best infantry divisions in the world. There is a winner in swift strike after all. Every person who is concerned with a stronger America.
The Big Picture is an official report for the armed forces and the American people. Produced by the Army Pictorial Center. Presented by the Department of the Army in cooperation with this station.